Warrior to the ring, please. To the blue corner, Blake Quintana.
I think it definitely was. You see a belt, you see something shiny, you want it. You want to fight it. Even if it's not one of the major titles, it's preparation for when those type of when those the four major sanctioned bodies call you and say you're ready to fight one of theirs.
Because some of these belts can lead to an NABO or NABA or NABF, which again had that tag, the relationship with some of the big time sanctioned bodies. Don't forget too, it's a wonderful card thus far. A lot of action. We still have our main event slated for 10 rounds. Jordan White taking on Joe Perez. We also have our 8th round co-main feature, Damon Nicholson taking on Victor Garocha. And as I mentioned, this one, Quintana from Nebraska, turned pro back in 2018. 4-round unanimous decision win against Christopher Hawkins in March. Michael mentioned he's 22 years age, taking on the veteran, if you will, the 35-year-old Brandon Chambers. And on the line is the ABF Atlantic Featherweight title. And Chambers is extremely tight, extremely close to our promoter this evening, Tony Jenner, obviously. They are one of Baltimore's finest, if you will, both with the background in law enforcement. And also, Chambers and Jenner have this unique relationship, which we will get into in a moment as we see Tony right in the ring right there. They're flashing the ABF Atlantic belt.
Well, whatever it's worth, it's a very nice looking belt, though.
Any jewelry.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Warrior to the ring, please. To the red corner, Brandon Chambers.
So we saw a fighter in Hall that had a layoff. Chambers throughout his career has had a layoff as well. 2 stoppages his last 3. He's the type of fighter that basically fights for those that have believed in him throughout the course of his career. As I mentioned, very tight with the promoter, Tony Jenner. Of course, Jenner is like a big brother and is also the godfather to Chambers' youngest. He's a family man. He's 5-0-1, a couple knockouts to his ledger. Officer of the Year in Baltimore 2018 and 2019. Really good personality, very engaging guy. And I think for either of these men, whether it's going to be Chambers or Quintana tonight, to have an opportunity to fight for a belt means something to him.
Yeah, it's going to mean a lot, especially early in their career. You know, the answers questions for you. When the belt's on the line, they're not going to be able to step up. You know, and the trick is to get to mean more with each fight.
We always see how the fighters respond when the belt's on the line. And of course, when the lights shine the brightest, and they're certainly shining bright tonight, live casino at Hotel Maryland in Hanover, Maryland. The Hall at Live as we get set for the official introductions for this one. It'll be slated for 6, the ABF Atlantic Featherweight title on the line. It'll be Quintana. It'll be Chambers for the official introductions. Back up top to our ring announcer, Henry Jones.
This bout sponsored by Zoe Johnson's Vital Hydro Alkaline. Introducing the principals first. Found out the blue corner, he's wearing the black, red, and white trunks. He weighed in at a light and tight 121.2 pounds. Undefeated as a pro at 4-0 with 1 KO. Hardcore Conor. Lester in the house, all the way from Kearney, Nebraska. Fight fans, please welcome Blake, the Kicking Tana. And we're going to find out the ring for him. He's wearing a red and tan trunks. He weighed in at a ready for ring business, 122.8 pounds. Also undefeated as a pro. At 5-0-1 with 3 big KOs, the native son has returned home. Sponsored by Big Bank Boxing, Minnie's Ice Cafe, Technical Financial Group, and Velocity Dance Studios. Ladies and gentlemen, the Baltimore Banger is back, still representing the Eastern District. Here is Brandon, the Hitter Chamber. Sixth round or less, this is for the vacant ABF Atlantic Super Bantamweight Championship.
Definitely. I can say the fights I've seen of Brody Chamber, they have never been boring. So, you know, this fight could just evolve right to like good old scrap, or it could stay like this. We have to see what each fighter feels about each other.
And if you're Quintana making the way via Nebraska, you're a long way from home, as they say, and you're fighting in someone's backyard, so you can ill afford to give up rounds.
Yeah, you definitely don't want to give up rounds. Nothing can be given away. You know, you have to, and you have to be decisive in one of these rounds. You know, some of these judges may have judged his fight before. They know what they expect from Brody. They don't know what they expect from you. So, anytime a round's close, they may not have. They're always going to might lean towards him.
Sure, it's like the preconceived notion that they already have the. Perception is, we call this guy's fights, we know when he starts to pick up the pace here and there. And we're seeing right there Quintana asserting himself right now, round number one. Oh, he just caught Chambers, just missed with that over the top right. Yep. So Blake Quintana throwing a lot of punches early on.
Yeah, Blake Quintana's definitely fighting like he's a long way from home. He's fighting like he has to be voted to get his plane ticket back.
Good combination up top. Sneaking that right body shop and then went right back upstairs.
Yeah, definitely want to mix up the punch selection, especially when you got a guy with the high guard. I mean, throw some shots, keep his guard up, sneak one to the body. Eventually, as the rounds go by, kind of start slipping down a little bit.
Get those hands to drop and then come right back up top. Late stages. Round number one against Skippy for
ooh,
six.
Right,
yeah.
Right through the guard.
Been smart. He went right back downstairs. In Chambers.
Oh, another